Good afternoon, Jose. How are you?
I'm doing okay. It's a little rainy day, but the weather's finally starting to warm up, so I
All
can't
right.
complain.
Well, you are my little bit of sunshine today. I'm so glad that you took the time out to actually interview with me. I appreciate it. You guys,
Welcome.
this is Jose Corpus. He is the author of the book, Hadamai Al Brown's biography. Well, it's his take on his biography, Black Ink, and he's also the author of New York City's Greatest Boxers.
That's right.
Welcome.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Absolutely. So I just want to jump right into it. We got about 5 minutes, Jose,
Okay.
but I just want to touch base with you and just kind of understand how you your thought process. I mean, I know that you're not only a boxing enthusiast, but you're a fictional writer as well. Tell the
Right.
people a little bit about like how you got started in writing and how your journey actually started with Panama Al Brown, if you will.
Well, I mean, I always had an interest for writing ever since like high school. I did study journalism. I got a 2-year degree in journalism. I worked for a little while in a newspaper. It's a tough business as far as it not being high paying, so I kind of got away from it. But thanks to the internet, about a dozen years ago, I started getting back into reading, and I started noticing some voids, some stories that were either being told wrong or were not being told. And I just took it upon myself to fill in those gaps and tell those stories. And that's how I got into Panama Brown, because he was one of those stories where bits and pieces of what happened to him were being falling off and being neglected. So I didn't want that story to be forgotten. So I
Okay.
got into it.
Well, for those of you who do not know who Panama Al Brown was, Panama Al Brown was the first was Latino box the first I'm sorry, the first boxing world champion, the first Latino boxing world champion. And of course, as his name indicates, he was from Panama. If you guys are into boxing, this is a phenomenal book. He's a phenomenal personality overall. Like he was very flamboyant. I mean, I was surprised in the book, Jose, honestly, that he was as flashy as he was back then. Like because we didn't live back in that time frame. Because if you guys didn't know, he was born in 1902, and he went through the Roaring Twenties and all that stuff. It's just boggling, like how flashy he was.
I mean, we tend to think that they were a lot more conservative back then, but it does seem that he really had no problem being himself, and he refused to cover up to society standards. He was a guy who
Absolutely.
was he was himself all along.
Absolutely. Now, I read a little bit upon you, and I saw that you had written an article for Narratively, and you said that
Right.
you're also through our conversation, you said that you're writing a new, is it a new book that you're writing or a new article, a couple articles, or tell me a little bit about what you're doing and where
Okay.
I mean, yeah, just tell the people
Sure.
about.
I mean, articles I write occasionally for the sweetscience.com about boxing. I'm getting into short fiction also. Keep a lookout on that, because I'm trying to wedge my way through whatever door is opening in the journals. I do have one more book that's been, well, it's been marinating for a while. There's a couple of sections that got to be completed. That's also about boxing. It's called Bad Hombres. It's what it's going to be called, and it's about the pioneers of Latin American boxing.
Okay. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing that, but well, reading that book when it comes out. I do have a question for you, Jose. What's the hardest thing besides, of course, not getting a lot of money up front in the industry? What's the hardest thing that you can, the most challenging thing about writing that you've come across? And that's pretty standard with everyone.
Well, writing fiction and writing nonfiction are very different. The hardest thing, I don't know if it's the hardest thing, because there's a lot of things that are hard, but you have to practice your craft. You have to be true to the story. Don't be
Okay.
afraid. Don't hold back, right? You don't have to insult anybody, but if the story takes you into a place where you're not comfortable, You got to write it or let someone else write it, but don't change the story, right? The story is the way it is.
Okay.
The thing is, you really got to know your market. You know, for so many years, I've always been told, know your market, like for fiction, for example. And I'm thinking, all these years, okay, I'm writing about inner city. My market is inner city. It really doesn't work that way. Your market, you got to get your foot through the door and you got to get through the gatekeepers. And your market is really the editors, right? That's who you're writing for, right? And once you get through the editors, then they're going to put it out to their readers. See, most of these journals already have a built-in audience. Unless you're a celebrity, but very rarely you're going to come on board to a new magazine and sales are going to go up because you got a story that they never heard of. It doesn't quite work that way. They have a built-in audience of subscribers, and the editors only allow stories that they feel their readers are going to like and that are not going to offend any feelings or anything, right? So you have to know the editors. You have to know what those magazines put out, and you have to write towards them. Like if you're going to write for the New Yorker, for example, you have to write a certain way. Your ending has to be a certain way. You're going to write for different magazines. The style has to be a little different. So when you ever hear people say, know your market?
Yeah.
Don't think of people, the buying public, right? Think of the editors who publish it in those journals.
Wow, that is some good pieces of nuggets. Like, honestly, I never thought about it that way. I always thought of it as the readers. I never thought about it as the editors.
Right. Well, before it gets to the readers, it's got to get past the editors. So that's okay. Yeah, that's one thing I would say. It'll save you a lot of time when you're submitting.
Okay.
To know their writing style and their materials, and not just like if you have a magazine that just concentrates on let's say historical fiction, don't send them a piece about the future, right? Because they're not going to do it. So beyond that, though, you have to actually see writing styles. Some of the fiction is more character driven, some are more dialogue driven, and you have to look at it that way.
So know your craft. Just read. Right.
And know what
to read.
You need. Well, yeah, but not just read, but you have to read it like an editor would, because then you'll start seeing a lot of these magazines put out very similar stuff. Right. You don't have to change your story, but you do have to kind of, you got to play ball. So you have to change your writing to fit their style, their taste.
Okay.
Right. Okay. Your story don't have to be affected. You don't have to compromise yourself, but know that you have to
write specifically towards them so they can.
If you want to come out in those journals, you have to adapt, right?
Okay. Well, Jose, we're just about out of time, but I wanted to have you tell the people how to get in contact with you and how to purchase your book, Black Ink.
Oh, it's available online through Amazon, Barnes & Noble. I have a few copies left. I got about 25 copies laying around if anyone wants an autographed one. I have a Twitter page. It's Jose Corpus at Corpus Writer. I think that's how you put it. I'm not even sure.
It is. I'll connect it. It's Corpus Writer.
Mm-hmm. It's Corpus Writer, right? Yeah. I'm not super active on it, but I do go on, you know, every other day, so I can get messages there.
Okay. Okay, good. You guys go out, buy this book, connect with Jose. He's amazing. He's very easy to talk to. So definitely support, and good luck to you, Jose. I will be talking to you soon, and hopefully we'll be working on a couple projects together.
Yeah, that sounds good, man. Also, if anyone's interested in Panama Al Brown, let everybody know. Recently, there's a couple of projects coming out on him. Like there's a movie coming out on him in Panama. There's one coming out in French. So he's finally getting some.
I heard about it. I'm so excited about that.
Yeah, so he's having some sort of revival, and I'm glad I've been a little part of that, you know, with the book. But keep an eye out on that. And if anyone's interested in following me, I do have some more stuff coming.
I am excited, and of course, you know, anything that you share with me, I'll share with my followers, because I do believe in your craft, and I love the book. So thank you so much for your time today. Jose, and hopefully we'll be talking soon.
Yeah, we will, man. Just feel free to call. You know, I'm here. I'm always here in my driving school, Champion Auto School in Brooklyn, New York. You know,
all right.
Phone call away, man, you know.
All right. Angie, thank you so much. Have a good weekend.
True. Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.